So I'm here with esteemed paranormal investigator Lee Brickley, and we're trying to get to the bottom of the truth of these black-eyed children. What can you tell us, Lee?
Well, as far as we know, this is a single entity that's been appearing on Cannock Chase since the early 1980s. It takes the form of a small girl, no older than 12, and she's been terrifying local residents over the past couple of months due to a wave of new sightings.
So then, you say 1980s is when this has been recorded. Is that the earliest date?
Yes, it's just over 30 years ago is the first recorded report, and although there were a number of sightings back then, things died down a bit until late 2012. December 2012, in fact, was the first time I received a new report from a member of the public. And interestingly, it was in fact the 21st of December 2012, which, if anybody's into doomsday prophecies, they'll know it was rather an important date.
What are your theories on the origin of these disturbing sightings?
Well, up until yesterday, I would have told you that I believe the black-eyed child to be some sort of ghost or demon. However, last night I received a sighting report from a local lady that blew my mind and effectively blew this case wide open. Now, I can't go into too many details about that at the moment because it's still early days. All I'm saying is don't believe everything you're reading in the newspapers and don't believe the things psychics are telling you on TV, because the truth about the black-eyed children of Cannock Chase could be more terrifying than even they imagine.
Would you say it's still safe for visitors to come and enjoy the chase?
Well, as far as we know, there have been no sightings where the black-eyed child directly caused harm to anyone. However, there have been a few reports that suggest it could be trying to lead people into dangerous situations. And for that reason, I would just request that anybody who comes on Cannock Chase keep their wits about them, keep their eyes open, and remain calm if they see the black-eyed child. Whatever you do, do not chase after it.
So then, Lee, over the past few weeks there's been a rise in UFO sightings. What can you tell us about that?
Well, yeah, that's right. I've received 7 sightings myself over the past 2 weeks of strange beams of light coming down from the sky onto Cannock Chase, and these are from separate individuals. But I would say that from the evidence I've seen last night and again today from this lady with the new report, that the lights in the sky, UFO sightings, whatever they are, and the black-eyed child of Cannock Chase could be linked, but it's a bit too early to go into too many details about that. I should be able to reveal a little bit more in about 3 weeks' time.
What's going to happen in 3 weeks?
I don't know. I think it could be something big.